You don't have to plan on becoming a teacher to be selected for YMLA, Young Male Leadership Academy. The program has served minority males in the area since 2007 and exposes them to all sorts of tips for a successful future. Real talk from educators who are currently in the trenches to students who have their whole lives ahead of them.
It's more than about being a teacher. We're also going to look at career and college readiness, and we're going to look at leadership skills.
Like how to handle introductions.
I've learned a lot of communication skills, like when you're talking to someone, eye contact, like how to shake someone's hand the right way, just things like that.
I tell young people, if you can't speak for yourself and you can't communicate with your employer, your teacher, or your professor, you're not going to move forward because they're not going to know what you want.
16 students from the Bowling Green and Warren County school systems were selected for the Young Male Leadership Academy.
The main message that we want to give the students is for them to dream big and to pursue them and to work hard at them.
Joseph Boyd knows firsthand how a teacher can make a difference.
I didn't really grow up as like a happy kid. Like I used to like get in trouble a lot. I used to have like anger problems. I used to be a bully basically.
His fifth grade math teacher, who is now his assistant principal, had a huge impact.
Having the right teachers to believe in me and having teachers who look like me made me change and made me see that I can be better than what I am.
When you take a look at the classrooms, you look across the United States, look right here in Warren County, you don't see many men of color in the classroom.
The inspiration, the connections, it's all spread out over the academic year, helping these young men realize the sky's the limit. The group recently returned from the Educators Rising National Conference in Orlando. They will have an end-of-the-year banquet tomorrow night featuring keynote speaker Wayne D. Lewis, interim commissioner of the Kentucky Department of Education. With this week's View from the Hill, I'm Amy Bingham.